In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create an animated Saber outline with a free plugin in After Effects. So let's get to it. So here we are in After Effects. And before getting started, make sure you install Saber plugin. The link is in the description. It is completely free. After you install it, come back to After Effects, choose a video of your choice and create a composition with it. And then here we are. I'm going to use this car wheel as the example and apply the Saber to the car wheel. First, we need to duplicate the clip. So let's select it on the timeline, go up to Edit, Duplicate, or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. Now we're going to apply the mask to this duplicated layer at the top, and then we're going to track that mask throughout the video. So first, let's create the mask, make sure the top layer is highlighted. Then I'm going to click and hold the rectangle tool until I see the ellipse tool. Since the wheel is rounded, I'm going to select the ellipse tool. If you need any other of these, make sure you to choose that one. Or if you need a custom path, you can select the pen tool. Now I'm going to click and drag from the center of the wheel, holding Ctrl and Shift keys to get the proportional mask. And I'm going to do it something like that. Now, after creating the mask, switch back to the selection tool or press V on the keyboard. And if you need to move any of these individual points, you can click and drag to select them and move them however you like. So I'm going to slightly adjust the mask to better focus on this inner rim. So we're going to track it throughout the video. So after you've adjusted the mask, right click on the mask that's on the timeline and select track mask. Then you should see the tracker panel. If you don't, go up to window and select tracker. And then you should see this tracker panel. Now for the method of the tracking, I'm going to choose position, scale, rotation, and skew. I found this to be the most accurate in terms of tracking the mask, so I'm going to choose it. Now make sure you are at the start of the timeline, of course, and click on track selected masks forward. So click on it, and then After Effects will take some time to analyze the footage and track the mask throughout the video. Just patiently wait until this is done. And after it's done, you'll see a lot of keyframes have been generated. And if you preview the video, you'll see that the mask is fixed to the object that we set it to. And now we can add Saber. So let's open Effects and Presets window, search for Saber, and add it to the top video layer with the mask. Then head over to the Effect Controls panel. First, let's go to Customize Core and set Core Type to Layer Masks. Then open Render Settings and set Composite Settings to Transparent. And here you can see that the Saber has been applied to the mask that we've created earlier. And now we need to adjust the look of the Saber pretty much. So I'm going to turn off the mask to toggle mask and shape path visibility so it does not interfere with the Saber. Then let's go up here to the presets, and here there are many different ones available. You can choose any one of your choice, but I'm going to go for neon preset to get a neon look. And then in the customized core, we are going to move to the first frame first of all. And here I'm going to set start size all the way to 0%. That will make the end thinner. And here, if we create a keyframe for mask evolution at 0 and move to the end of the video, then we increase the mask evolution. So I'm going to set this to 4. The higher value you put, the faster the animation will go. And if we preview this, you'll see how the Saber looks at the moment. So if this is a look you want to go for, it is completely fine, but I'm going to further adjust the Saber so it looks a bit better. So again, let's come back to the start. So here I'm going to set start offset to 50%. That will bring the end or the tail part a bit closer to the start. And you can see now Saber is occupying only half of the mask. I'm going to set end size to 150% to make this start or the end thicker and more glowy. And I'm also going to set core softness to 1. That'll soften this tail part so it looks a bit better. So if you preview this, you'll see that now the Saber looks a bit different. And to me, it looks a lot nicer. And that's how you create animated Saber outline in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.